going to hope that they save the best person till last, but I'm going to have to let you decide. And I know everyone's getting quite hungry, so it won't take too long, I promise. So, as you probably all know, Jellyfish is very much a data-led business. Everything we talk about day-to-day is all about data. And what we've done is cement our creative strategy by using Google's Vision API. We've basically just made it far more intelligent and work as hard as it possibly can. So as Alex mentioned, 70% of all revenue comes from creative, so it's really important to get it right, but equally it's important to know what doesn't work quite so well. And that's exactly what we've used this for. So we've increased performance by quickly and efficiently finding out, as I said, what works, but equally what doesn't work. So the principle behind the API is actually really simple. What it does is it looks at an image and it also looks at elements within that image. That can be anything from something like the peach. It can be the person's face, the sentiment they have. Are they happy? Are they sad? You know, it might sound quite simple, but all of these things collectively can make a real difference. It also can be down to things like dominant colours. There may be colours that perform far better than others, and that's what the API will enable us to do. So in collaboration with Google, we basically built a pipeline. So basically, we took our creative, we fed it through into the Vision API using data flow, and then it all went into BigQuery. From this, we then created some dashboards within Data Studio, and that helped us analyse and take all our findings away to move on to our next testing. So here's a real-time kind of example of how this could work. And it could be something as simple as two shoes or four shoes. And I imagine lots of you in the room will love these beautiful UGG slippers. Maybe not for everyone, but anyway. So the Vision API basically extracts elements of these. That could be down to the colour, it could be down to the background, it could be to how big the logo is. It basically could be anything and can go into any different retail space or any different company. It could literally be a group of people or a simple image. It's as easy as that. But the principle stays the same. So part of the process, we then did some analysis on this. So as a general rule, we then split it into different creative groups. And in this case, it was simple. It either had something or it didn't. So it could be grey, it could be pink. We then measured each group using this adjusted view click-through rate, which isn't particularly easy to say, and then essentially found out how many clicks from this were either viewable or measurable. What I'm going to do is just show you actually how the API works. So I'm just going to select this image. And what it's going to do, as it would do with everything, is analyse each element of the picture. So obviously we can see it's a cat. But there's lots of different areas that it will show us. It actually says that it's a British shorthair cat. There are lots of different things that this API can actually do, and this is just one of the elements of it. So the question was, how many shoes were optimal? And this was literally all they wanted to know from this. So they basically wanted to identify an optimal number within each creative. So we tried various variations of this to find out which worked best. Each image had a slight variation, as you can see. Some were actually closer to the camera than others. Some showed the logo more than others, or there was maybe one, two, or three pairs. But in this case, it purely was down to how many shoes were in each image. So our initial findings actually showed that we had a higher click-through rate with more shoes, but actually fewer of the creatives actually had less shoes, which then we knew actually performed better. So as a business, you will already have an idea of what your customers want, and this actually will kind of act as a middleman in some cases. You'll have an idea of what they want, you'll use this to maybe run your creative through, and then actually you would run some traditional A/B testing just to cement that that actually is the case. So when we ran our A/B test, it proved that four shoes did perform better, and certainly better than two and four shoes, and it corroborated our findings. We then created a case study for UGG based on our findings, and we rolled these findings into the case study where we showed the impact of AI and ML in our business process. Within this side, you can just see that actually using the Vision API along with our A/B testing, there was actually a 26% increase in the click-through rate of four shoes versus six. So basically, in summary, Jellyfish can help come up with much stronger creative based on your KPIs and actually come up with a solution that will work far harder for you and actually sit really well within your process at the moment. And we can help you understand your different business needs using it. Thank you.